Hello everybody, and we're about to continue our Let's Play series of Lords of the Fallen. Let's see where adventure is going to be taking us next. In our last episode, we worked our way through Upper Calrath again to get back into a whole new area, which was like the entry level of Bramis Castle. We had to actually fight Andreas of Ebb and the Iron Wayfarer. Let's head over to our seedling that we planted. And now we're working our way into the actual castle, which so far has been pretty interesting. Okay, I think we're heading on over this way next. Oh, we got a friend. Oh. Oh, that didn't work. Oh my God. Let's exit Umbral. There we go. Oh, can we go through here? Does not open from the side, so it comes back down. Okay, where does this go? Oh, new seed spot. Not that we need it there. Looks like we're on the other side of where we were at the start of this area. Okay, not seeing any other friends waiting for us. Oh, got another one of these guys. There we go. Okay, we have a stigma right here. Okay, we have that path as well as nothing over that way. Take a look at that in a moment. I always kind of like to save stigmas for when I know we have an exit point. A charred letter. I don't know what that is actually. A partially charred letter, much of its text rendered illegible by time and damage. Okay. Looks like a good spot. Okay, umbral entity prevents our progress. Oh boy. Parasite. Ouch. Oh, down we go, I guess. Quite sure where we are right now. Oh, chest. Nice. Grinning axe. Open this. Fire ward. Where are we exactly? Oh, we're right here. Nice. Ouch. Oh, I guess we actually activated that. That's kind of funny. What is that? Oh, that's kind of disturbing. Okay, we have this path right here. I don't think we dropped down, though. Like, that just looks like death down there. Must have just been a shortcut. Oh, wait, this way. There we go. Okay. Got a parasite to deal with, or a entity to take care of. Every time.
Come on.
Okay, there we go. Okay, now we can go over on this side. Climb up the ladder. And we can get that one right there. And I think that should do it. And we can head over here. Does not open from this side. I think this one does not. Oh, does this one open? Oh, we can walk right through. There we go. What awaits us up here. There's always something. Okay, Lord Axe, that looks like it would be cool. Just keep working our way on up. Oh boy, what is that? Oh my god. Okay, let's get these dogs out of the way first. That's a special kind of enemy. Okay, unlocked a path to that. Oh my god, completely forgot about that. Didn't even look at the tail. Okay. I actually think I see a vestige over here. We can get to it. Oh, just in time. Whew. Didn't even check the tail on that one. Looks like our other friend does not respawn. So Let's take care of these dogs again. Okay, I wonder where this elevator goes. Oh, right over here, nice. Okay, Argent Hero. Bigger Skull. And of course, Path to our Seed. That looks like our path of progression, as well as this area. Not quite sure where that goes. But we did pick up the charred letter, and I have a feeling that it's a key item. So I wonder if we're supposed to... Let's see, where was it? I know that we have our tortured prisoner NPC around here somewhere. I think that sounds like something she would use. It's charred, she does fire. I think it's the vestige of forgotten guardian upper Calrath. There we go. And then she should be right over this way. Right through here. Right over here, I think there's an enchantress. Or, actually, she's further along, maybe. Oh. Okay, there we go. We have a friend over here as well. There he is. Okay, hand over the charred letter.
Faded and half-ruined or freshly wet with ink, they can comfort like an embrace or pierce like blades. Words or okay, got pierce that part. Like...
Anything we want to buy?
My invitation reached you.
I don't think so.
A kindness.
Okay, let's hop on out. Now we can continue on. Let's see, warp to our vestige here. Bramis Castle, vestige of the Bloody Pilgrim. When he who came to be known as the Bloody Pilgrim arrived in Mornstead, he was seemingly as just another traveler amongst many of like mind. But when those around him began to suffer the same agonizing, blood-drenched death, it became clear he was no ordinary pilgrim, and the number of corpses left in his wake only grew with his receipt of the umbral lamp. In truth, the Bloody Pilgrim was no hopeful, hallowed sentinel, but rather the last of the ancient band known as the First Pilgrims, rumored to have ascended to a wondrous afterlife at the end of their mythical journey, but who in reality found something far more terrible awaiting them. Wow. Okay, let's see if there's anything we missed over here. Well, oh. Hey, look who it is.
Talk, talk, talk. That's all you do. Cajoling arguments, tempting pledges, a deluge in which a woman drowns, and from which a puppet emerges. Deathless one, please bring me proof that the child is not just a figment behind fractured glass. That he... Deathless one, that the child...
Okay, something about a child we have to look into. So we have this path that looks like... Actually, that looks like death. So we have this way to go. And, oh, this way too. Okay, Ring of Infernal Devotion. Nothing that way. Ring of Infernal Devotion, what does that do? A ring of charred and melted metal inflicting burn buildup simultaneously and fixing ignite buildup. Ooh, that would be good for a fire build. Can't go that way. Looks like we're going... Oh, got a runer over here, actually. Kind of see him way off there. There we go. Some items. Paladin's pendant. Okay, large delirium shards. So we're pretty much set for that stuff. As far as upgrades are concerned. What does the pendant do? Increases strength and endurance attributes. That's something we will be needing. I can see somebody over here. Oh. Somebody was shooting at us. There we go. Explosive bolts, nice. Sadly don't have a crossbow that we're, oh, there we go. Okay, we're looking pretty good here. Not seeing anything. Oh boy. Quite the reach on you. Okay, so we got that path. And this path. Probably a good spot for a seed, actually. Map of Bramis Castle. Okay, so we have that direction. I think we should probably check out that other way, too. A purifying bomb. Oh my. Okay, nothing that way. Holy Ward. Okay, what is over here? This door appears to be locked. Oh, he's back. Oh, yeah, I could drop down right here. Nice. Looks like we've got a path over here. Oh my god. Always those guys. Down here, grab this. Okay, there we go. Just hop back down, I wonder. Not seeing much. Nothing over that way. I feel like we're missing something. Because it wasn't like a huge point to even be in Umbral. We picked up much. Okay, so we go this way. But then again, I'm not really seeing anything, so maybe that was everything. And rest. Okay, let's hop on in to the castle. Okay, ignite salts. Ouch. Sure. feel good. There we go. Got an item right over here. Eviscerating spear. Okay, there's that path. And this door. Stigma. And that's our seed. Push our ladder down. There we go. Okay, we've got another runer. We've got a proselyte. Okay, so we came from that direction. Okay, that is blocked off. Okay, there we go. Got a chest right over here with upgrade materials. Oh boy. Got another friend hanging out. Probably some doggies around here somewhere. A smoldering ring, what does that do? Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. We'll take a look in a bit. We are under attack. Okay, that shattered everything over here. Okay, we'll take an umbral path at that at some point for that direction. Oh. There we go. Okay, now we can take a look at the smoldering ring. we can find it. A ring which frequently emits tiny sparks increases resistance to burn. Let's pull this lever. And we're twisting that staircase around. Conflagrant Sears, that's what those are. It's over here. That's kind of cool. Oh boy. Okay, Heavenly Vial. Maybe that wasn't the spot I was thinking. I was thinking about that spot where we kicked that guy off. Right before we went into Umbral and ran into that gargoyle-like creature. Shortcut. Nice. Right by our seed. I actually wonder if this is a pretty good stopping point for us. About 40 minutes in. Though I don't want to reset everything. So many enemies we've taken down. I wonder if we can push a little bit. Down here. Oh my god. Oh, this is nice. A little shortcut, maybe? Awesome. I wonder if we can kind of work our way around here and see if there's any enemies that we need to take out. Oh, parasite, of course. Oh, That fire spell is always a fun time. Not seeing the parasite anywhere, sadly. Oh, there it is. Might be out of reach, though. Of course, we got a Reaper right by us. Oh my. Oh, of course, the parasite healed him. I wonder. Hop on down here. There we go. Yeah, I think we got everybody. Nope, not gonna get fooled by this again. Okay, that's an umbral path. What else is down here, though? Ouch. And there we go. Holy salts. Not quite sure where that is. Okay, that was our path. We're just right back up here again. Okay. We still have to go this way, I think, actually. Let's cross on over. Oh my god. That was a little close. Always a pleasure. Lord's Bite. I feel like we've almost gotten everything. Nothing to do with a child, though. We were trying to find something related to that for the tortured prisoner. Okay, that looks like something new. I think we took out the rest of this room. Oh, the staircase. We can go this way. Parasite, of course. Okay, I feel like that should be... I don't know if we have enough time for the whole upstairs area. Might want to just save that for our next one. So let's make our way over to our seed that we planted. Which should be right over here, I think. There we go. Okay, awesome. Well, definitely a fun episode, working our way through Bramis Castle. I think we're getting pretty close to... Feels like we're getting close to the end, if I had to guess. At least the end of this area. But either way, I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in, and we'll be talking again real soon.